Both teams taking the temperature of this series in Game 1. Now they know what to expect. Let's get going on Game 2 of the Western Conference Quarterfinals. Bill and Brent Berry. Allie LaForce, our reporter tonight. Allie, take it away.
Hey, Brian. Devin Booker finally playing winning basketball in Phoenix. He said, quote, "This city deserves it. I've been here grinding, trying to get to this point. The team and the culture that we have, this is the best position that we've been in since I've been here, to make those dreams come to life."
And that's great to see, Allie. Thanks for that. A look at the starting group for the Pelicans. They've got Larry Nance. Also, Brandon Ingram out there. C.J. McCollum is out there with Jonas Valanciunas. And it's Jones in at the two spot. And for the Suns, the duo inside, Johnson and Ayton. Paul and Booker, the talented backcourt. And it's Bridges in at the three.
Here we go.
So Phoenix will get the first possession. To the inside. Oh, and the jam by Ayton!
Booker has established that he can score and now showing that he can play make.
Nance outside. And here's Jones. Always a nice way to start. Makes his first one. Here's Booker. Pass to Paul. Over Valanciunas. Nice spin off the left rim and in.
That's nice vision there. You see that pass, you make the feed before the defense has a chance to react, and that opens up a much better opportunity to score.
Now here's McCollum. Stolen by Booker. And the Suns pushing it up now. Paul against McCollum. A little mid-range shot is up. Another one falls for Phoenix.
Just love to see Chris Paul operate in that area. Slows himself down. Great balance. It's one of his many strengths.
Bridges against Ingram. Six on the shot clock. Shoots over Booker. That's short off the rim.
Oh, can't punish the defense for leaving him open that time. That's a frustrating miss for a really steady jump shooter.
Bridges finds Paul. Up and over McCollum. And another basket for Phoenix.
Well, they can't miss. 4 for 4. And warming up the burner.
Outside Ingram. Beyond the arc. And again, New Orleans, no good. The Suns have gone 4 of 4 from the floor. Perfect start. Johnson with a bucket.
That's a good find from Ayton, understanding the defensive scheme. And he just waited for his teammate to be open.
Here's McCollum. They get the rebound. Great positioning on the putback.
Huge putback. This guy plays with so much energy.
I don't know anybody that goes after the boards harder. Here's Paul. And it's Phoenix with another.
And they've settled in quickly today. A nice flowing rhythm to their offense.
The Pelicans trail. Pass to McCollum. Shoots over Bridges. McCollum with another miss. And it's Phoenix's ball. They're on a 12-4 run. Johnson, soft touch off the glass. Johnson's got his second basket on the night.
They're really working the paint now.
Offensively, it's been a struggle for them.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Here's Bridges. And the shot goes down.
And what's working here? Each guy is willing to make the next pass.
The Pelicans have gone 2 of 6 from the floor. Outside Jones. Ingram, the pass to Nance. And here's McCollum. To the paint. And Valanciunas gets it to go on the assist by McCollum.
You just don't want to give away points by giving away passing lanes. McCollum right there, waiting for one, then threads the needle.
Here's Paul. And it's good as he snugs it right through the net. Paul's got 10.
This has been just a dreadful start for them defensively. Not good at all.
Here's Ingram. And that one drops for him.
Brandon Ingram showing some toughness that time. That's a strong finish.
Pass to Aiden. And that one makes him 2 for 2. He's in his rhythm.
Really taking charge of the game, largely with a detailed interior attack.
Well, how good have they been on the inside tonight, just getting down into the painted area and just dominating, controlling that spot.
Yeah, feel for him right now, guys. He's much better than this 1-for-4 start. He just needs to relax a little bit out there and let that game come around to him.
Now here's Paul. He's got 10. And Ayton with the stuff.
So far, they're owning both ends of the floor. We'll see if they can keep this going.
Like tonight, that all the hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy and keep comfortable.
New Orleans calls timeout.
And things are always changing throughout a game. Teams have to adjust on the fly.
And timeouts are a wonderful opportunity to just settle in and recollect the thoughts of your entire team. Not just the guys playing, but the entire team.
And the Pelicans going with a whole new group out there. Now here's Graham. And he's going for the oop here. Hernan Gomez gets the bucket.
Against good D, Hernan Gomez very aggressive, and he makes the play.
Here's Payne. Off the left rim and out. For New Orleans, they've got 6 of 10 attempts to fall. Here's Graham. No good there. That would have cut it to single digits. Now here's Payne. Gets his second attempt to go. Now he's 1 for 2.
Boy, I like their energy coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were 4 or 5 boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have checked 6. I mean, they're doing everything out there.
Now here's Hernan Gomez. Graham buried from 15 feet out.
Can't talk enough about the subtleties in that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
Hook loose. McGee with it. Hernan Gomez there. Pass to Sharon. No one near him. Pulled the shot a little left. The bounce goes his way, though.
Nice job by the team to set up Sharon on that play.
For New Orleans, they've gotten 7 of their first 12 shots to go. There's 1:17 left in the opening quarter. And a moment here to take a look at some hustle stats for Phoenix.
Their frenetic defense has been impressive, putting ball handlers on the defensive and turning them over as well.
Another big aspect has to be the fast break and transition play, really looking to go up-tempo tonight.
Here's Murphy. The Suns getting their last shot to go. 5 on the clock. Sends it home from three-point land.
He's consistent from out there, especially when you give him that kind of room.
Floats one, and Payne lays it up and in.
Wow, they're really being taken advantage of defensively out there. No rim protection whatsoever.
Pass to Murphy, and here's Hayes, defended by Payne. Unloads, and the Pelicans get another bucket right there. 2 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Outside Paul. We've got 13 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Footer. It's deflected.
It's not with extreme athleticism that really gets to that shot, but the anticipation and the timing, those help.
Well, what a performance by Chris Paul. He's been the story for the Phoenix Suns. He made a big impact, scoring 12 points in the quarter. Back after this. And he's always been a coach on the floor. Chris Paul is a communicator.
with anything, whether it's business, work, relationships, whatever, it's communication. And I think that's something that we're doing an amazing job of right now. And that's communicating, talking through things, and making sure, even when it gets tough, that we continue to communicate.
And CP3, never shy, Grant.
Never shy indeed. Always holding himself and his teammates accountable.
And let's get you back to the action as game two is getting underway. And guys, the Suns enjoying a nice lead here.
Oh, what I love was that first quarter was all about leaking out and capitalizing in transition.
It felt like they knew that there were openings in transition and just wanted to keep trying to feed that, get out quick.
Jay Crowder is out there with JaVale McGee. And then it's Landry Shamet, then it's Aaron Holiday, and it's Payne in at the point. That's the Suns five as we get into the second quarter.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations, getting good looks inside throughout the half.
Hayes has gone 3 for 3 from the floor. Now Holiday. Driving inside, pass to McGee. That one falls. Nice feed that time from Holiday. And the Suns lead by 13.
Like a matador. Ole! There was no defense. That has to be one of the easier shots I've seen tonight.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
Outside Grant. And another three for New Orleans.
Two teammates connecting right there. Slick feed.
Down low. A nice shot by McGee. McGee's got his second basket of the game.
Yeah, their defense is starting to wear down. That's three straight buckets at the rim.
Defended by Payne. That one goes. Count it. Phoenix calls timeout. And a new group getting ready for the Suns. DeAndre Ayton, he's checked in for McGee. Johnson comes in for Crowder. Bridges, he's checked in for Shamet. And it's Devin Booker in for Payne. There's the steal. Here's McCollum. Oh, it's blocked. It deflects off the backboard. Pass to Bridges. Booker with it. It's stolen. And here's Ingram outside. And the Pelicans hit again from deep.
They're getting more and more consistent, which means more dangerous as Brandon Ingram knocks down three.
Now here's Booker. And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second.
Ooh, how sick was that, guys? I mean, he makes defenders look silly with moves like that.
McCollum against Johnson. And that one's good. McCollum's got his second basket of the night.
That's a great read on the pick and roll by McCollum. The defender backing up leaves him no hope of affecting that shot.
Holiday passes to Ayton. Here's Booker. Just 5 on the clock. The Suns need to get off a shot. Holiday from long range. He can't hit that time. And it's New Orleans taking it the other way. Outside Ingram. Pass to Jones. McCollum outside. Nance outside. Inside. And that one's good. Ingram. And it's now only a 5-point Phoenix lead.
Brandon Ingram's advantage when he's down low like that still comes through in his length.
To the inside. And it goes. As the official calls the foul, count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line.
One shot.
The free throw's off from Ayton.
DeAndre Ayton, born in the Bahamas and came to the United States in high school to become one of the top prospects going into college and then becoming the first overall pick in 2018.
Holiday finds Booker. And here's Ayton. On the wing, Holiday. And he's in the books. Now one for two.
And I absolutely love the attack mentality, even with the bigger defender on him.
Yeah, that's an awesome finish there for sure. Not allowing that big guy to have his way or alter the shot.
New Orleans calls timeout.
Oh, my. Their coach does not look happy, and I can guess why. Their interior defense has been struggling.
No, they're not preventing them from scoring, and if you can get to a high-efficiency shot on the floor, and that's the paint, you just keep going.
Chris Paul, he's checked in for Holiday. New Orleans has gone 3 of 5 from the perimeter in this game. McCollum against Paul. McCollum, the pass to Valanciunas. And he lobs it up to the rim. Oh, what a nice defensive play to disrupt the lob. For three, Booker hits a three-pointer. And it's a 12-point Suns lead.
Catching and shooting with confidence. Devin Booker letting it fly.
Here's Ingram. Oh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take two free throws now. It's going to be on DeAndre Ayton.
Man, he made sure to get his money's worth on that foul.
And he drops a first.
Well, when you make these kind of improvements in your game, you're putting in a lot of work in the offseason. Brandon Ingram growing up right in front of us.
Both free throws good from Ingram.
At this point, you might as well go ahead and chalk up the points when he's at the free throw line. Pretty much automatic.
Booker. And Booker with the jam.
Chris Paul came into the league playing unselfish, continues to do so. What a dime.
The Pelicans have gotten 7 of their first 9 shots to drop during the second. Here's Jones. 3 shots, 3 baskets. Great efficiency so far.
It doesn't get any easier than that. The defense has to play better.
Booker finds Bridges. Paul with it. Nance covering. It's stolen by Nance. Deflects the pass. Stolen by Ayton. Pass to Paul. To the middle. Here's Booker. It's good. The assist that time from Paul. Paul's got his 5th assist in this one. The Pelicans have gotten 8 of their first 10 to go. Great shooting here in the second quarter. Shots good by McCollum. McCollum's got 6.
Well, CJ McCollum can go from second gear to fourth gear and back to second gear. A defense's nightmare.
Here's Booker. And it's good. Off the back of the rim and in. And the Suns lead by 12. Outside Ingram. Back to Jones. Blanketed by the D. He fights to the rim for the layup. Give him 8 points now.
And that play never gets old. The pick and roll will still be an offensive staple 100 years from now. Trust me.
Phoenix calls timeout. And the Suns will go for a different look here. McGee, he's checked in for Ayton. Crowder comes in for Johnson. Shamet, he's checked in for Bridges. And Payne is subbed in for Devin Booker. Right side Payne. Shot on the wing. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans.
Won't see him miss that one too many times.
Yeah, that happens. Important thing is for players, just don't beat yourself up and make a miss like that cost you another play.
Gets it down to single digits. Ingram's got 10 points now, just in this quarter.
This is a one-man show right now. He's on a mission to get him out of this hole.
Hayes against Crowder. Payne, pass to Paul. Here's McGee. Six to shoot. Over Graham. And the Suns miss again. 3 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Here's Hernan Gomez. He gets it in there. And it's now only a 5-point Suns lead.
When you use it right, the pump fake's as effective a move as there is.
Here's Paul. Fires at the elbow. That shot missing. And so a close game as we wrap up the first half of play. The Suns on top, leading by 5. And we'll be right back after halftime to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Well, for the Suns, getting out to a 2-0 lead in the series would mean so much to them.
Great to have you with us again as we return to our coverage of round one. Chris Paul having a dominant impact in this game.
I like how they control the tempo and play to his strengths.
Yeah, this is showing that they're not going to play at anybody else's pace but their own.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining 2K Sports and our coverage of this first round. Second half underway. Here's who Willie Green's got on the floor. We've got Jonas Valanciunas, Brandon Ingram out there with Larry Nance. Then there's C.J. McCollum, and it's Jones in at the two guard. Step back and squared up. Ingram's got 14 points.
Brandon Ingram, a constant threat on the offensive end. And a little bit of work right there in the mid-range.
Paul against McCollum. From 13 feet, down it goes. 14 points for him.
Well, looking into the gaps of the defense there, he's not going to miss many of those when he gets to that ring.
Pass to Jones. Shot is good. Off the back rim and in. Second half rolling along. About a minute played here. McCollum against Paul. Now here's Bridges. It's good. The assist that time from Paul. Bridges has got his second bucket of the night.
That's pretty steady from Bridges. Does not let the contact throw him off one bit.
McCollum against Paul. 11 feet out. Again, the Pelicans good for 2.
Well, the talk at halftime must have been a good one. Right now, 3 straight buckets to start the quarter.
Pass to Ayton. Outside Paul. Clock at 6. Over McCollum. And the Suns getting another bucket right there.
Adds to their lead. They've been able to rely on him all night.
Paul against McCollum. Again, the Pelicans good for 2.
I'm not sure what the coach said at halftime, but whatever it did, it's lit a fire. They're now 4 of 4 from the field to start their offense here in the second half.
And that one's good. Paul.
There's always these nights where Chris Paul tends to get a little bit hungry on the offensive end. We're seeing it play out here.
Ingram with the ball. Now guarded by Ayton. And there's the lob. Paul with a steal. In transition, here come the Suns. Here's Booker. Hey, he's now 6 for 6. He is cooking right now.
And right now, that's 5 buckets in a row. Looking like a well-oiled machine coming out of the break.
Pass to Valanciunas. Down low. Here's McCollum. Ooh, good finish at the rack off the slick feed. McCollum's got 12.
Well, McCollum undersized at his position, at least in terms of his strength. But he can play that way because he competes. That's a tough one there.
Paul can't get it to go.
Well, that's not a shot he's ever going to pass up, and he shouldn't. Despite the miss, no defender anywhere near him. He's got to shoot that one.
I just love the aggressive finish.
Now, I'm thinking he's sending a strong message with that jam. Paul into the lane. And it's in there. Paul's got 9 points now in the second half.
Just can't say enough about how much of the game Chris Paul sees, exploiting every single hole in the defense and an excellent penetrator.
Time called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over. It's been quite a game for Chris Paul.
At some point, you have to try and force the ball out of his hands. But that's easier said than done.
And the Suns making a change here. Holiday is checked in. Pass to Murphy. Here's Nance. Here's Murphy. He's guarded by Bridges. McCollum, right side. Gets to the corner and hits it. 14 points for him.
He's been incredible in this half. Anytime he pulls up from outside, you think that's Bottoms.
And their offensive game plan is clear. Get it inside and go to work.
New Orleans has gone 4 of 6 from three-point range thus far. Outside Jones. Pass to Murphy. Now Valanciunas is covered by Ayton. Here's Murphy. Nance, the pass to McCollum. From the arc. Rebounded by Johnson. The Suns have gotten 7 of 8 shots to fall in the third quarter so far. And there's Bridges. That's good. On the assist by Ayton. And it's an 8-point Suns lead.
Bridges doing a great job of getting on the inside to find a way to score.
Pass to Murphy. And here's McCollum. And it's in after a nice bounce off the right iron. McCollum's got 16.
This is not a player who likes to be trailing in any game. That lights a fire.
Out of bounds. Suns ball as Phoenix keeps possession. McGee, he's checked in for the Suns. Hernan Gomez is checked in for the Pelicans. Hayes comes in for Nance. An outstanding defensive play to earn the Mobile One block.
Oh, you could feel the playoff intensity in that block. He's playing some extra aggressive defense out there.
And so here's Phoenix. They've led by as many as 14.
Well, Picasso couldn't have drawn that up any better. Perfect execution off the inbound.
Here's McCollum. Ooh, he's looking good tonight. He's drilled 9 of 15 so far. Phoenix has gone 1 for 2 from outside the arc in this third quarter. Over to the wing. McGee in the post. Hernan Gomez there. A nice shot by McGee.
You know, they're really being bullied right now defensively. 8 of the last 10 points have come from inside.
Here's McCollum. And it's good. 2 points. McCollum's got 20 points.
Not bothered by getting hit on that play, probably because CJ is capable in the air to make an adjustment.
Bridges passes to Holiday. Oh, an amazing finish with a hand right in his face. Holiday's gotten 4 this quarter. McCollum against Holiday. Here's Jones. That's in. Coming off an assist from McCollum.
Even though they're still trailing, he continues to be lights out from the field. What a competitor.
It's Booker on the wing. Over Jones. Booker can't get it to go. The Pelicans trail. Pass to McCollum. Now here's Jones. it up with both hands and rips it down.
And nobody putting out much of an effort to stop him.
Surprising, in a close game, a lack of energy on defense.
On one side, inspiration. On the other, devastation.
Phoenix calls timeout. Phoenix making some changes. Crowder, he's checked in for Johnson. Shamet comes in for Bridges. And Payne is subbed in for Holiday. 55 seconds left in the third quarter. Booker, the pass to Crowder.
The defense there doing whatever they can to protect the rim.
All right, a look at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for the Suns.
They keep piling on the assists, guys. They haven't cooled off any in that regard.
The other thing they've done is had penetrating passes inside, in the interior, plenty of points in the paint.
First one falls for him. The Pelicans making a switch here. Ingram's checked in. Good on both. New Orleans has got 4 of 7 threes to go so far in this game. There's 42 seconds left to play in the third. Another basket. He's now 6 for 7 in the contest.
Man, that's now 10 straight points in the paint. I'm not sure what's happened to their defense, man.
And he's going for the lob. And McGee with the stuff.
And the lead increases on a crazy offensive sequence.
Man, the dunk alone would have been incredible, let alone the fact that it came off a 10-point pass.
Brandon Ingram at that size, able to survey the entire floor and make a play.
The Suns leading. Booker with it. He's got 13. Just 3 on the clock. And he lays it up and in. Booker's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Devin Booker will score by any means necessary, and that time over decent defense, getting the contact.
And as we end the third quarter, a great game. Both teams playing well. The Suns on top, up by 6. After a quick break, we're coming right back with the start of the fourth quarter. Thanks for joining us again for round one of the NBA playoffs. And it's the Suns with the ball. They've led by as many as 14. Payne and Booker, the backcourt duo. Jay Crowder is out there with Landry Shamet. And it's McGee in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. So that's the lineup on the floor for the Suns.
The defense so concerned with Shamet and his shot-making ability, he makes the play that time.
The Pelicans with possession here. 9-point game. Outside Grant. Shoot from 12. Again, the Pelicans good for 2.
Oh, what great action we've seen tonight. Hard to imagine a more entertaining game.
No, this is about as high octane a game as you're going to find.
The shot by Payne, no good.
He's so good at getting to the rim. Maybe tries to get a little bit too cute with that one. I thought he'd lay it straight up and in.
Ingram. And another basket for New Orleans.
Well, Ingram did not let that hand in the face bother him one bit.
Pass to Shamet. Now here's Crowder. This one for three. Nails it from beyond the arc. And the Suns lead by eight.
He made the most of that opening, teaching the defense a lesson.
Ingram. Good. And Graham with the setup. Graham's got his third assist of the night.
Hey, they're just getting pushed around inside.
Crowder outside. And he lobs it up top. Trying to go for a lob there. Excellent defense and anticipation to stop it. And the shot goes in. Ingram's got 10 points here in the second half.
Well, the defense has to do a better job, but when Brandon Ingram is on the break, those strides, man, he takes up a lot of ground.
Booker on the take. Score that basket. His eighth out of nine shots here today.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
Yeah, the coach pretty smart for zoning in on him and giving him opportunities to stay with that confident play.
Yeah, these teams are playing with incredible energy.
Timeout.
At least in the second half they have been. The first half wasn't played anywhere near this intense.
Phoenix calls timeout. Phoenix making some changes. Ayton comes in for Shamet. And it's Chris Paul in for Payne. And a change for the Pelicans. Valanciunas has checked in. And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what Monty Williams was saying to his team. He complimented the three-point shooting. He said, quote, "It's one thing to get the look, it's another to bury it. I believe in you guys. I think you've got this game on lock. Let's go out there and let's take this. Guys."
Good job there, Allie. Thanks. Pass to Graham. Uses the glass on the layup. Graham's gotten four this quarter.
That's what you call playing big. He just stays committed to the attack mode.
Tip of the cap there. I mean, that defense was good. The finish was better.
This is when your interior D has to be on high alert.
Outside Ingram. Steps back and shoots. The shot's good. Ingram's got 24.
And very few teams rely on mid-range jumpers nowadays, but that's been their preferred way of finding points.
Basket's good. And the Suns lead by six.
A good tempo on that play as Chris Paul was in place for that jumper.
Crowder against Ingram. Ooh, poked away. Stolen by Booker. He's still feeling it. And it's Phoenix with another.
And that's the guy they're going to keep going to, as they should. The lead's only going up if they keep feeding him.
Ingram against Crowder. Unloads from 13. Hits the front of the rim and out. The Suns have gone 7 of 8 in this fourth quarter. McGee passes to Crowder. Booker with it. Hayes picks him up. Pass to McGee. Yes! And it's Booker with the setup. And now a 10-point Phoenix lead.
Impressive. Their ball movement has been excellent tonight.
Timeout called. The Pelicans.
And the other team is running all over them right now.
The timeout before the timeout here, maybe just to cut off the momentum and have a chit-chat with the team to settle down.
And now we present our New Balance player of the game, C.J. McCollum.
Can you say vintage? Wow, this was a vintage performance. I mean, so much of the game is about the three ball today, but his focus was going hard into the paint and doing damage from inside.
Johnson, he's checked in for the Suns. Bridges comes in for Crowder. Here's Jones. Knocks down the triple.
So far, he's a can't-miss player, a superb scorer who plays to his strength.
Here's Booker. And there it is for him. Booker's got 8 points in the quarter.
And they've really managed to dominate inside.
Pass to Hayes. Here's Ingram from deep. And Ayton pulls it down. Ayton's got his fourth rebound in this one.
Since hitting two triples in the first half, he's been non-existent from out there. And let's face it, when you're down this many points, you simply can't let him get that good of a look.
Teachable moment there. Lapses like this are backbreakers.
Throws it up high and finished off by Hayes.
I know CJ plays the two-guard position alongside Lillard, but he does have point-guard vision, and that's a great find.
And Ayton with the stuff.
As long as passes are in that area, Ayton's going to get up and go down.
New Orleans has gotten five of their nine attempts from deep to go. And here's McCollum. Shoots over Paul. He hits the back iron and sinks it. McCollum's got 22.
Doing what he can to help shrink the deficit, but it has to be a team effort.
McCollum against Paul. Battles through traffic and lays it in. 27 points for him.
And Paul takes pride in scoring past the defense. He's used to getting roughed up a little bit. Sometimes he causes most of that, though. True grit from the little man.
You got to appreciate the consistency. Night in and night out, he brings it.
Phoenix has gone 2 of 2 from outside so far in the fourth. Paul against McCollum. Got a hand on it. And they recover it. Ayton passes to Booker. Just 5 to shoot. Back to Ayton. And Ayton with the stuff.
Defense unable to stop DeAndre Ayton that time, getting inside and using his frame.
Paul against McCollum. And the layup is good off the glass. McCollum's got 7 points here in the quarter.
And that's how you draw it up right there. A screen to shed the defense, a quick move to the bucket, and you get the lay-in.
Paul with it, and it's Ingram picking him up. Let's the three fly. Paul, shot is off. New Orleans has gotten 6 of 10 three-pointers to drop. Here's McCollum, and McCollum slams it in.
McCollum on the inside, driving in and not backing down. He got up there.
Outside Johnson. The kick out to Paul. Pass to Booker. Ayton with it. McCollum defends. Three-pointer Bridges. The Pelicans pull it in.
And they have to know that any hope of a comeback is gone.
Well, realistic at this stage of the game, they're going to lose this one, but will they take something from the loss?
Yes! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5. 24 seconds left in the fourth, and now they decide to foul intentionally. And they've been moving the ball really well tonight.
Good things come to those who take good shots.
He hits the first one, and that increases the lead to 6.
Well, Booker still has some upside, one of the best young scorers that we've seen in the NBA in the last decade. He's already an established star, and the sky is the limit for this guy. Now he just wants more wins.
That's how you protect a lead. Build it out with clutch free throws.
New Orleans calls timeout. They trail by 7. We've got 22 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
Trying to extend this one, but it seems futile.
Yeah, this is the classic too little, too late. The effort coming and not enough time for them to get back in it.
Here's Snell. Three-pointer, no good. 17 seconds left in the final quarter. Oh, there's the alley! And stolen by Hayes. Pass to Snell. The three is up. Laces one from 3.
Now that's the kind of passing right there that makes a difference, not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
Phoenix calls timeout. close game sees Phoenix taking this one. And this win shows they have the momentum so far in this series. Up 2-0 now.
They just look so confident out there. They're playing selfless ball, and their chemistry has never looked better.